Hello, welcome to another episode of the Crufts Couch Pod. Wow, I am so excited to dive in today. I've had a really potent transformational morning simply in my yoga class, something that I'm going to regularly. And little did I know that I would get such an intense download and release today. And so I am so excited to share really the lesson that I've learned from it, the codes, the transmission of what I'm embodying now. And I really get that this is going to be really transformational for you when it lands. Now, it might not land right away, or it might, you know, make sense cognitively, but not at the physical embodied level, and that's okay. This is kind of how these things go when we're getting new information or ways of being from people. Sometimes we don't hear it at all first, and then we cognitively hear it and kind of get it. Okay, that makes sense, but we don't really get it. We get it, but we don't get it. And this is where the real-time embodied experiences, where you have a real-time life example, is what really teaches you the most. And so I got that when I was asking the universe for what would it take for me to show up more fully expressed as me, more confident, what would that take? And I had a real-time experience in yoga today that I'm so excited to share with you. So before we dive into that, a little housekeeping. I want to let you know that my membership Activate is opening again. I am literally so obsessed with the folks in there and the membership in general. I have worked with entrepreneurs forever, facilitating mindset transformations and healing to unlock exactly these things that I'm learning as well, showing up more confidently, being fully expressed, being courageous enough to choose what works for them, all those sorts of things. And so I created Activate back in September and really looking to come at it from a place of doing business different, just doing it different. You know, I was in a ton of different traditional business trainings and courses, and then realized those were not really working. Things kept flopping when I attempted to just replicate what someone else was doing. And so when I looked at that and started to join alternate containers that supported a different model, wow, everything just landed. And that was really the birth of Activate, where I wanted to create this space for folks to come at business from a different way, focusing on their energetics, focusing on them, and really creating a business that feels good for them. Because for what purpose are we choosing this, right? It's not an easy road, so to speak, to work for yourself. Yes, there's a lot of freedom and amazing things, uncapped income and all these possibilities. And it can be terrifying. And, you know, not everyone sells that because that's not the sexy thing to sell. That's not the sexy thing to say. Yet it is all those energies. And so I tell folks when I first opened up Activate, I had an idea of the first couple programs. Basically, each month is a different program. And I also told them to trust that they know. If they were choosing it, then their soul knew this is exactly what was required for them, and that you actually don't need to know all the details. You don't need to know every program that's coming up next. Because the reality is, I create as I go. So I'm aware of what the next month is bringing, and January, it's fuzzy still. I'm not too sure. I love to follow the energy with that. And that's what I teach folks, rather than needing to go into all these masculine over-planning, over-scheduling. And that all just created a lot of contraction for me. That's not how I function best in business. And so I create similarly and hope to normalize it for other folks. So basically each month is a different program in and around all the energies, pragmatics that I believe are imperative for you as an entrepreneur. No matter what your business is, it's applicable. Now, I really do speak from my own coaching mentorship experience. However, no matter what your business is, I have folks in there that have all sorts of different businesses. It's really applicable because it's really all about the energy and who are you showing up as? Who are you being? What is your mindset going into these things? See, in this reality, we're really taught, well, how do I do this? Well, I need a really specific, you know, mentor or coach who's going to talk to my example exactly so I can implement it and just replicate it. Wow. Hi, raise your hand. I've done that a million times before. And now I'm getting just something totally different in how I learn. I'm seeking to learn from folks in a way where I'm questioning, okay, who is it they be when they create this? What is their mindset around it, right? And how did they approach creating this? Not how did you make X dollars? How do you get more clients? How do you, how, right? That is a scarcity mindset. That is a place where we don't trust ourselves. And this is what I teach folks how to do. How, right? Because ultimately, it is them embodying an energy that they learn for themselves. So I encourage you, you know, there are a ton of amazing people to learn from and jump into support with. Really seek out containers that are returning you back to you. I know this can be scary, especially in the beginning. I was there. I wanted someone to just tell me what to do, show me how. I was like terrified, right? My nervous system was so freaked out of making this leap. Yet I can tell you that trusting you is the magic sauce. Because every time I've created business from that, it does amazing things. And anytime that I am just trying to replicate someone else or be someone else, it flops. And so it's really about knowing what you know and putting that out into the world, right? But in this reality, we're not taught to trust ourselves. We're taught to seek answers outside of ourselves and have someone else show us how. And what if there is no how? And I'm going to talk a little bit more about that today based on my experience in yoga today. So activate, we are going to talk about being the boundary in December. I've had a lot of folks pinging me for that. I've had real-time experiences in my business with that. And I get that it will be really impactful for folks. Being the boundary around, you know, in and around your time with business, being the boundary with your clients, being the boundary with your employees, being the boundary that fills you up, right? Not being the people pleaser, bending over backwards or trying to create based on what you think your audience wants. No, like all of that is scarcity. All of that is trying to get energy. And that's not where we want to be. We want to be in the space of abundance, showing the universe that, yes, I trust this will happen. This is where I'm going. This is what feels good for me, right? Because when you follow that, that is what manifests the reality that you are desiring. It's when you feel good, right? When you are choosing things that light you up and feel good for you and not have you in resentment. So December is going to be all about being the boundary, and I'm doing a wicked bonus right now. So if you join Activate, it's a 6-month commitment because, you know, we need to hold our feet to the fire a little more than a day, a week, right? We can tend to quit on ourselves. So a 6-month commitment. However, if you join before December 2nd, you get access to my November program, which was Invite, Don't Sell. And wow, that program, we're doing our last call this week, but you'll get access to all the replays. That program had some really potent transmissions in it regarding being the invitation energy, because this is the energy that creates possibilities, invites people to something totally different. Because if you're here and you're listening to this podcast, then I know you are different. I know that you desire to see something different in the world. You desire something different and you know something else is possible, which means that's business too, right? We can't do business the old way that is disempowering our clients, that is attempting to sell based on nervous system activation, right? It's empowering them to know that they know, to trust themselves when they invest, to choose from there. And so it is not the typical thing of, well, like, get this many clients and, you know, all of that, because this is a different energy. We're no longer functioning from those vibrations. So I'm really excited because this membership is just everything to me. And for folks that also don't know, it includes my full Courage to Choose membership and portal, which is just a huge, oh man, just a mass creation of content and masterclasses, present and past. And so you just get a ton of stuff to binge on right away. It's just all your foundational things that are just so needed from a mental and mindset stance. So, wow. Okay. That was a lot about Activate. More came out, and I love to always follow the energy with these things because to me, that's what creates the greatest, right? I can plan and plan all day long, yet sometimes we just got to get out of our own way and allow things to happen. Allow what needs to come out, right? Because that's what creates ease on our bodies. So I want to share with you today about my experience on the yoga mat this morning. So as I was mentioning, I asked the universe to show me what it would take for me to show up more confidently and fully expressed as me. I've been following and finding a lot of new coaches and mentors that I'm just so excited to learn from, and just seeing how fully expressed they are online, how confident they are. And I was just looking at that for myself and realizing that I was still hiding to some degree. Now, it's not like a light switch here where you're hiding and then you're not hiding, right? On, off. No, I get that it's much more like a dimmer here, right? You shine a little brighter and you shine a little brighter and you hide a little less and you hide a little less. And, you know, I could spend a lot of time looking at, well, for what purpose do I hide? Like, why do I do this? You know, and I get, well, some of that might be relevant and interesting. I like to look at what's efficient. So I like to look at, well, what else could I choose here, right? If I'm hiding, okay, but what else is possible? You know, I am aware that social media can be a crazy ground and there's lots of judgment on there, and that it has taken me some time to reveal more me. And I can go into all the reasons and justifications as to why I hide. Yet is that really relevant to me choosing something else? Now, recently, my father-in-law passed away, and I was thinking a lot about that transition and the death experience in general. And so it pinged me recently when I tuned into what are the major kind of life lessons folks have when they're on their deathbed. And one of them was, People, there was more sadness or regret, if you will, which I don't totally love the word regret, but there was sadness around not being fully them, not really showing up as them, really, you know, bending over backwards to please others or hide or mask or just not be the person that was them. And that really, really hit me because to me, when I'm looking at all the things of, you know, what creates a fulfilling life and business, and gain so lost in the trees and the weeds of, well, like, financially, how's the business doing? And how many clients came in this month? And blah, 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 and all that business. It kind of all didn't seem relevant because we always desire more. No matter what you have, you will always desire more. More expansion, right? Because you're an energetic, expanding being. So you're always desiring more. So I was looking at, well, then what would it take to be joy now, be happy now, feel fulfilled now, right where I'm at, and be me, show up as me. And so today I'm in hot yoga, and you know, it's after the holiday, and I've been in other fitness classes, but hot yoga, man, that's just a whole other beast to be in if you've ever done it before. And I could tell, you know, my mind was a little off, not totally off, but, you know, yoga really shows you whether you are distracted or focused, whether you are in a judgmental soup or you're in allowance, whether you're in fear or you're feeling courageous, because it's really about flowing through poses and creating strength in them, yes, and balance. That really does require a mind focus, right? The minute you might get distracted, you might fall out of a pose, or you're starting to go in judgment, you might fall out of the pose. Or if you're going into fear, you're unwilling to try it. So today we were trying handstands, and you know, trying with a spot, like basically starting on your hands with your feet on the ground and then kicking one leg up and then the next so it reaches the walls, right? So we have the wall as a support to be in a handstand. And, you know, you see kids do this all the time and just like tumble all around and do this. And yet as a 40-year-old adult, it feels quite different. And as I edged near the wall today, I just remember feeling this almost like wash of paralyzation come over me, feeling paralyzed in, oh, wow, this is going to be a process. Because I knew, I've been going to yoga for a while. I have the strength. I know I have the strength to do this. Yet what is it about just flipping upside down that has me paralyzed? And for me, it's generally around the fear of getting hurt somehow. Now I can relate it back to having some major health traumas in my life and, you know, maybe being triggering, you know, trauma in that regard. But to me in the moment, that wasn't relevant. I was just acknowledging, okay, this is more of a mental hurdle for me. I know I can do this, but it's going to be a mental hurdle. So I was starting with the belief that I wasn't really on the spectrum all the way to the end of the spectrum of, I can do this, I got this, right? I see it as a spectrum from the I can't to I can. It's a spectrum, again, not a light switch. I was closer to the I can with a lot of trepidation, with a lot of, you know, kind of the, how is this going to happen? What if I hurt myself? And going into some doubt of hurting myself to some degree. So I share this because I started off with a shaky mindset. You know, a lot of times we talk about beliefs and mindset in attempting things and doing things. And sometimes folks share it from a place of like, believe it so strongly, you have to 100% believe it. And I just don't agree with that. I believe you can be right where you're at, right where you're at, right? And to me, that was a shaky belief, if you will, today. But a willingness to try and just push my nervous system edge. And so I made a few like hop attempts, if you will, just to kind of be in my body of the feeling. And I adore this yoga teacher. She came over and she kind of reaffirmed the, you have the strength for this. You can do this. Let me spot you. I'll grab your leg so that you can touch the wall and know that you are there. And I did it. I was in it and I just immediately had this huge release, right? Immediately started crying, not like sobbing, but like the tears and the sweat were falling down my face and then came out of it and realized that was just such a pivotal moment, such a healing moment that I pushed past the edge, that I, even though in a shaky, nervous belief, did it anyways. And I love these examples because yoga has just taught me so much, but having something like this in real time to show me that, okay, I can do this. I can be nervous, excited, fearful going into something, and I can still accomplish it. Was it on the wall with a spot? Yes. Was it a little wobbly? Yes. Did I not hold it forever? Yes. Did I get into it? Yes. Yes. And so where is your perspective on these things? And so what I've gotten from yoga specifically is it's a couple things. It's about getting the geometry of your body, right? The teacher showed us like, look, here's how you do it. Make sure your hands are like under your shoulders and you just flip up and here you go, right? Done. She does it with such ease. And you could go into like, wait, okay, my hands are placed right here. She said 12 inches from the wall. So let me make sure. And then bend this leg and then straighten this leg and then use enough momentum, but not too much momentum. Blah, blah, blah. Like, right. You could go into all the, how is she doing it? But the thing is with it, you have to learn how your body works. You have to learn the momentum, the weight distribution of it, right? In order to flip upside down. And everyone's is going to look different. Everyone's doing the same pose, but it's all going to look different, right? So how is that related to your life and business? It's gonna look different, right? There might be similarities, but it's gonna look different. And you have to figure out how it works for you. And I've seen this really dynamically, even in other poses as we were learning, I think it was like crow pose. And, you know, the teacher had her knees in a different space on her elbows or her arms that worked for her. And when I attempted that, this was another day, I attempted that in the same place that she did it. I'm really good at like mimicking people my whole life. And it would not work. It didn't work. Right. And so then I had to tune into, well, wait, how is this going to work for my body? And so I tuned into how it felt. And so I lowered my legs a little bit and then I was able to lift my feet. Right. So it was really about just applying the energy that she bees and her approach to it and then applying it to me. And so this is what I want people to get is there is no how. Someone really can't tell you how. They can show you how they did it, right? They can show you what they beed, how they thought about it, what else is possible, how they navigated disappointment. And it's really the energy of it. Because if you attempted to try things the exact way they did it, right? I saw that in crow pose or even in the handstand. It didn't work. It wasn't working for me. It's the same with your life. It's the same with specifically in your business. You trying to replicate someone else doesn't create the magic. And so I was really reminded of, you know, kind of an energy that we've lost as kids. As kids, we had this willingness to try, natural courage, right? And willingness to go after it over and over again, willingness to fall, kind of fearless, right? And specifically, even just as we started to learn to walk as a kid, right? You stand up, fall down, you stand up, fall down, take a few steps, fall down. And it was just like, yeah, that's the norm. Like we just, this is what's happening. Okay, try again. Okay, choose it again. Choose it again. Choose it again. And I talk about this a lot because it's such a relevant example of an energy that we've let go of as adults, that we become blocked by, you know, all the things, traumas, fears, judgments, beliefs. Yet, what is that energy of a kid that has no projection, expectation of The walking should happen now. The walking needs to happen today. Otherwise, I'm a failure. That's it. I give up. I quit. No. The walking happens when it happens. And not all kids start walking at the same age. They're all different. So what if you stopped comparing yourself? What if you stopped looking at others to show you how? What if instead you learned from others what they be, what their mindset was, what else was possible, right? What is the energy they're approaching things with? Because that is what's going to create something totally different. So if you take away anything from today, I would say, what does it take for you to follow you? Now, I'm not saying don't ever work with anyone or like, you know, just totally be a monk on the top of a mountain and don't listen to anything, don't consume anything. What I am saying is get in places and spaces that support returning you back to you, that support trusting that you know. This is why I love learning from the mentors I'm with, including that yoga teacher, because she very much is focused on teaching folks to learn what works for them. Not, this is how I do it, so you should do it too. And that has transformed everything for me. And being in containers and spaces have sped up everything I've experienced. And I shared with folks that on my social that I was really looking actually into doing a yoga teacher training specifically with this teacher because I just adore the way she teaches. And I get that there is so much possibility in it for me. I have no idea for what purpose I really want to choose this. I didn't really have a desire to teach yoga. I just know that it is rich with life experiences. Like today, real lifetime data, experiences, energy, so that I could share with you guys, so that I could learn myself, so that I could support my continuing evolvement, evolution in everything that I'm teaching. And so I don't I have a general idea what the yoga curriculum is, and I kind of don't really care. No, it's like, to me, it's not about that. When I choose programs, it's not about that. It's what is the energy of it? What am I aware of? Right? And so today was just even more confirmation that spending more hours doing this is just going to be an amazing contribution for me. So I wonder what that is for you. Until next time.